8 days after the murder of activist Narendra Dabholkar, the city crime branch has finally picked up a suspect in the murder case from Pune. Well, that's the latest in the Narendra Dabholkar murder case. The police has made a breakthrough of sorts. In fact, it is now interrogating the detained suspect. This has happened 8 days after that shocking murder of activist Narendra Dabholkar. Remember, he was the one fighting for superstition, against superstition rather.
ह्या गुन्ह्याचे काय आहे की व्याप्ती मोठी आहे. गुन्हा करताना अतिशय खबरदारी घेऊन केलेला आहे. पाठीमागं काही पुरावा राहणार नाही याची खबरदारी घेतलेली आहे. गुन्ह्याचं ठिकाण असं निवडलेलं आहे की त्यावेळी त्या ठिकाणी जास्त लोक असणार नाहीत आणि गुन्हा केल्यानंतर त्या ठिकाणाहून वेगळ्या दिशेने पळून जाण्याची करता रस्ते आहेत. यामध्ये कोणीतरी सुपारी दिली असेल आणि सुपारी देऊन हे गुन्हेगाराकडून हत्या केलेली आहे. या गुन्ह्याचा जो उद्देश आहे तो त्यांचं जे काम होतं त्या कामाला विरोध करणाऱ्या शक्ती व्यक्ती यांच्याकडूनच झाला असेल अशी परिस्थिती निर्माण झालेली आहे आणि त्या दृष्टीनं सर्व प्रकारच्या शक्यता विचारात घेऊन आम्ही तपास करत आहोत.
Unless and until the person who has done this act and the mastermind behind this kind of act are caught and not brought to justice, I think we won't be satisfied. It's very difficult for us to name anybody, but yeah, there are obviously two possibilities which come to our mind. Basically, the fundamentalist groups which were upset as he was fighting the battle of reason, and the organized cults who also get exposed due to his work against them. So obviously those are two things which we have strong suspicion about, but it won't be good on our part to name anybody specifically because police is doing their work.
All right, joining me is Megha for more on this story. Megha, we were just listening to one of the police officers there who was clearly mentioning that it seems that this is part of an organized crime and also that the mastermind perhaps is still at large.
Well, yes, and that's the more disturbing part, that it's been almost over a week now and there has been absolutely no clue of who could have been behind this cold blood murder of Mr. Narendra Dabholkar. Now, what we do understand is that the questioning of a certain person who has been detained from one of the Sanstha organizations in Goa. That's a Hindu radical outfit in that has its the huge office is its installation in Goa. From there, we know a certain person has been detained. Not correct to take his name at this point in time, but we were given to understand that he was detained last evening by Pune Crime Branch, a team of Pune Crime Branch in Pune that, of course, got him to Pune by 7 in the morning. And right now, as we speak, the questioning of this person is on. Now, it has, of course, this investigation has drawn a lot of flack, with both the Chief Minister and the Home Minister having to take tough questions at different points in time over the last 7-8 days, because nothing and really nothing has come out of all the investigation that has happened over these days. And the problem that they are citing every now and then is that it seems that it is a contract killing. And of course, in a contract killing, investigations do tend to stall. And it is sometimes it becomes a major problem to crack through and find out who ordered the killing. That seems to have been the problem in this case also. Like, we just heard that sound bite that the person said that right. The main mastermind is still at large. But with the questioning of this person, it almost seems that probably the police have got some clue, and maybe during the course of the day they might show him as arrested, and that then would be the first arrest in the case if that happens.
Right, Megha. So are we to believe that now with one detained, the police might be in fact closer to cracking the case and also getting its hands on the mastermind?